How's it going?
Hey, how's life?
Where the hell's my ratchet wrench?
Here for your bike?
Having a look. That okay?
We had a couple of guys go down the nest a few weeks back. You know, freaker nest. What do you call them? A female cat. What do you call them?
Deke, I've been thinking about what you were saying about doing something to make a difference around here, pay back the camp.
I'm listening.
Do you got a few minutes? I want to show you something.
Yeah, guess I can spare you a minute or two.
So where are we heading?
You ever been up to the caves north of the lake?
I know. Come on, see if you can keep up.
Okay, let's go.
I got marsh duty anyway this morning. Gotta see if any freaks are stuck in the muck out that way.
When's the last time you went up there?
Been a few years, I guess. When I was a boy, we used to live in that damn cave. That old man sort of fancied himself a geologist.
Sounds like we got a couple. Freaks stuck in the mud, I mean.
Yeah, sounds like.
Nice work. Hey, Schizo's just found a new man for the job.
You know what Schizo can go do.
Anyway, as I was saying,
we spent hours talking about how all these caves were formed when lava flows would harden on the outside, but the molten cores would still flow like buried rivers. You got the big caves that drew in the tourists, like Metolius up there. There's way more than that, riddled all over these parts.
Okay, we're coming up on the highway. We gotta be quiet.
Jesus Christ! This is why you brought me out here? Smell a bunch of goddamn freaks?
Yeah. Okay. Come on, follow him.
Wait. Follow him? Where the hell are we going?
You'll see. Come on.
Don't get too close. Stay down.
This doesn't seem all that smart, even for a goddamn drifter.
Hold up. You remember telling me about how the tourists used to flood up from California in the summer, choke off Highway 97 and the I-5 freeway?
Yeah, in July, folks smelled almost as bad as these here freaks.
Well, you weren't wrong about one thing. These freaks, the big groups, the ones that some call hordes, I think they're the reason we can't get their numbers down.
What do you mean?
Think about it, man. I've been out here in the shit collecting bounties for more than a year. Boozer 2, Ricky, Schizo, a few others. How many freaks you think I killed?
A few.
A few. Yeah, but their numbers never go down.
You got a friend?
Too close. Stay down.
What the hell are we doing, Deke? This doesn't seem all that smart, even for a goddamn drifter.
Hold up. You remember telling me about how the tourists used to flood up from California in the summer, choke off Highway 97 and the I-5 freeway?
Yeah, in July, folks smelled almost as bad as these here freaks.
But you weren't wrong about one thing. These freaks, the big groups, the ones that some call hordes, I think they're the reason we can't get their numbers down.
What do you mean?
Think about it, man. I've been out here in the shit collecting bounties for more than a year. Loser two, Ricky, Schizo, a few others. How many freaks you think I killed?
A few.
A few. Yeah, but their numbers never go down. Never go down.
You got a point?
It's these hordes. Every night, there's a steady stream of them up and down the Sanium Highway. Thousands of freaks pouring into the Lost Lake Valley north of the Cascades.
You think they're coming up from California? The highway's closed off. No one's been south of the Sanium Pass in years.
It's not closed off to the hordes. Freaks are the reason it's closed off. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that the hordes come in every night. Not a goddamn thing we can do to stop them.
You got that much right. Lost more than a few men trying to back in the day.
Yeah, I know. I was there. And every horde that comes through leaves a few stragglers or gets busted up and scatters and just like that, freaks everywhere as far as the eye can see.
You don't need to see them to know that they're around.
We figure out a way to stop the hordes coming through, maybe we can make some headway, reduce their numbers.
Make it safer. Free up more farmland, irrigation.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we do that? You know goddamn well you can't take on a horde?
This is how. I'll be goddamn.
Yeah.
They stand there all day, hibernating or whatever the hell freaks do.
So what are you thinking that we...
Yep. Blow it the hell up. Stick it down to my there, there, and there. We bring down a mountain of rock. We seal this shit up.
Yeah, so we trap a few hundred inside. What good is that gonna do?
No, you don't get it. We seal this cave. Maybe they don't got no place to sleep. Or maybe this trail of piss and shit dries out, goes stale, and other stuff.
You got my attention. Okay, come on, let's head back.
All right, my knees are warmed up a bit. Let's see if you can keep up.
Yeah, okay.
Tell me, when does being out in the shit make you an expert on freaks? You spend your spare time just following them around, seeing what makes them tick?
Not exactly.
And how do you know about all this? About what a horde's gonna do, where they sleep?
A few days ago, I was riding north of Belknap Crater when a chopper flew by.
A chopper? What the hell?
Just listen to me. It was a black chopper. One of those Nero choppers that used to fly all over the goddamn place when the shit was going down.
And you saw one, still flying?
I followed him. I stole one of their radios. I've been trying to track him down, see if they have a base around here. Supplies. Shit, I mean, see if the feds are still alive, you know what I'm saying? They're out here doing field work of some kind on the freaks. They're studying them.
They got resources to do that while we're out here starving, fighting to stay alive.
I followed them up to the Grotto Caves. You know the ones?
Yeah.
They had motion sensors set up, measuring how many freaks used the cave during the day, and, Mike, it was thousands.
that right?
They said freaks all up and down the Cascade Range, south of Crater Lake and north up to Smith Rock, all use these lava tube caves to hibernate. So, we blow up those caves, maybe we have a few less to deal with.
Hey, this idea of yours, it's got some merit, but job like that, it's gonna take a fair amount of TNT.
He said you wanted help making Lost Lake safer. This is how we do it.
All right. Look, there's some things I gotta do, okay? But you meet me at the bridge in a couple of minutes. I know where we can find some.
St. John, you... supposed to be up at the farm an hour ago. My guy said he's got a shovel waiting for you.
Yeah, Schizo, about that, I'm busy. See, Iron Mike and I, we're just heading out on a run.
You and Iron Mike? Get your ass up that way today, or you and your gimp boyfriend are gonna find yourselves out in the shit. You hear me? Without a goddamn paddle.
Yeah, I'll get right on that. St. John out.
What do you want?
Nope.
Can I help you?
You got...
Ready? Where are we headed? This time you're gonna have to trust me.
Okay, where are we going?
You know what they used to mine all around these parts?
Yeah, mercury or something.
That's right, cinnabar. They extracted mercury from cinnabar. Folks back east think it was gold mines out here and silver. Not so. Back in the early 1900s, cinnabar was worth more than gold. To operate the mine, you need TNT for expansion, blowing out new tunnels, clearing cave-ins, that sort of shit. And to own TNT, you had to register with the county, keep copies of the keys to all your lockboxes with the commissioner.
Wait, the county courthouse? Where the hell is that?
Thought you knew. It's in the old federal building.
The old federal building. The one in Sherman's camp. Jesus, Mike. What the hell? You told me... You told me that you were never setting foot in that place again.
Did I? I don't recall.
You were drunk right after Joe was killed.
Did I tell you why?
Here.
No. Turn right here. This is it.
Mike, the place is gonna be crawling. I don't think this is a good idea.
Weather holds, we'll be safe enough. All right. That there? It's the old federal building. That's where we're headed.
Let's not go looking for trouble. Stay out of the buildings. Come on. We gotta head over this way.
Where are we headed?
Just follow me. He'll be on the commissioner.
And you know where he is? Where his body is?
Yeah, I think I do. You heard what happened here.
Yeah, everybody got wiped out, man, woman, and child. Only a few got out, and you were one of them, right?
Only two got out. Me and Nora. But it wasn't the freaks that took us out.
What do you mean?
Here.
Oh my God.
2 weeks in, the ammo was gone. Two sides called a truce. A meeting. Right here. Oh, we knew what was coming. We knew what was coming and we were prepared. Fight didn't last long, but it was bad. They had ammunition left after all, and well, they... Oh, hell, you can see what they did. Like I said, two people walked out of this town after all was said and done. And some days... I wish to hell one of them wasn't me. Commissioner's over there in the bean counter suit. Go get the key so we can get the hell out of here.
You didn't give a damn about sealing the caves. You brought me here you brought me here because you wanted me to see this.
Not true. All right, you got the key. We're gonna go get the maps to those mines, just like I said, and we're gonna get more than enough TNT to seal every cave in the valley.
Bullshit.
You are right about one thing. I'm not sorry you've seen it.
Not following you, Mike.
I am talking about the war that's coming. With the Rippers. The one that Schizo saw hot for. You think he cares how many die? On either side?
Black
Never
night.
Mind. Come on. Let's get this done.
Here's the door.
Place is locked up tight. Come on. Gotta find a way upstairs.
Smells like something died in here.
Newts. Yeah, I smell them. Bad. Okay. All right, this is it. Now we got maps to every mine in the county showing where they stored their dynamite. Okay, come on.
Hear that?
Yeah.
Weren't you expecting anyone?
Nope.
Do you have my back here?
Hey, I don't like starting trouble, but I'll finish it if I have to.
Stay behind me.
Hey, I could take care of myself.
I'm not saying you can't, but remember the last time that we were out in the shit.
Yeah, like I said, I'm staying behind you.
That's how it's done.
Jesus, what a mess!
You know why no one goes into Sherman's camp.
Addie finds out you're out here risking your ass like this, she's gonna be pissed.
Now, how would she find out about something like that?
Not from me. About the Rippers, why you wanted me to see that shit.
No, Deke. I always saw a bit of myself in you. Back in the day.
How's that?
You don't give a shit. Oh, you care about your friend. Don't want to see him die, but me? Any other goddamn person on the planet, I don't think so.
Caring will just get you killed.
Yeah, that's right. Thing is, not caring will get you killed just as easy. Good folks of Sherman Camp did was stop caring about anyone but themselves and their own. Easy to kill a man when he's just some piece of meat standing between you and what you need. Schizo wants to kill Rippers because he don't think they're human anymore. You don't count. He's standing in the way of what he wants. Well, I don't buy into that shit. I won't have it.
You know, Schizo, he wonders why I'm a pacifist. That's what he likes to call me. He thinks I'm gonna get everybody killed.
Well, are you, Mike? Are you gonna get everyone killed?
Freaks aren't gonna be around forever. Now, when they're gone, we're gonna need some folks around here to help pick up the pieces. Hey, look, hey. I don't like Carlos and his Rippers any more than I like Tucker or Copeland and his goddamn truthers. All right, but here's the thing, Deke. I'm not going out of my way to kill any of them. I've had my share of killing.
Even if Carlos comes for you?
My truce will hold. You can bet on that.
Hey, Blair.
I got all kinds of stuff. Good choice.
Well, Mike, I ain't gonna bet on that. Your truce ain't gonna hold. Yeah, for once I agree with Schizo. The Rippers, they ain't human. Not anymore.
Yep. Well, you would come back soon, huh?
wonder how Boozer's holding up. I guess I should go check on him. Hope he's awake.
Yeah, Mike, this is Deke.
I heard you brought in Shane Riley, but when I went to the shack to question him, he wasn't there.
About that, Mike. I tried to bring him in. I really did, but he, put up a hell of a fight. So he didn't leave me much choice, Mike. He didn't.
Remember what I said about how we do things around here?
Yeah, Mike, I remember.
Lost Lake out.
Brian, I'm at one of your beacons, the one outside of Rogue Camp.
Drifter, St. John, copy that.
Why am I here?
I show, Hilo incoming to that location now. Be ready. O'Brien out.
That's why I'm here.
St. John, they should have arrived at your location. Do you see them?
Yeah, kind of hard to miss. What do you need me to do?
Get close to the researcher. Remember, you have to stay in their proximity or I can't intercept their data.
Let me know when the LC's down.
You to plant one of those trackers on their helo. Their chopper.
I know what a helo is, O'Brien.
And you better have something for me.
I got someone I trust working on it. We'll know soon enough. Okay, we're ready to... upload the data as soon as you're close. O'Brien out.
So what's all you boys doing here, huh? Okay, I gotta place a tracker on that chopper.
LZ's clear.
Come on, guys, just gotta clear out. Can't let them see me. Got it. O'Brien, the tracker's set. Here he is.
Now 2060. We have now completed the survey of 24 nesting sites, including those at Marion Forks, Pioneer Cemetery, the Cascade Highway Lumber Site, the truck stop on the old Belknap Road. What was that called again?
Our Crazy Willies.
Yes, very rustic and touristy. Some things about the old world I don't miss. The Crazy Willies, south of the Belknap Crater.
I got a question, Doc.
Sure, it's not like I'm busy or anything.
The nests. Where do they build them?
We don't know.
Where do they only build them in, you know, building structures, cabins, things like that?
We have a theory that...
I mean, we never see them, but wild animals will build them. Trees or out in the wilderness, big houses.
You finished?
Sorry.
The guys back at the lab have a theory. I'm sure when they're ready to talk about it, they'll come rushing down to the barracks to let you know.
I'm just asking. I see things too, you know. It wasn't always a grunt.
Can I continue?
Sure.
South of Belknap Crater. Some areas of the Belknap Wilderness were not surveyed due to the proximity of nesting sites to human encampments. In particular, a large camp at...
Salome Hot Springs.
Yes. Salome. On Herod's birthday, she danced before them, whereupon he promised with an oath to give her whatsoever she would ask. She said, "Give me the head of John the Baptist," and the king was struck sad. For a resort.
Oh, shit.
Again, some things about the old world I don't miss.
Upload complete. Yeah. The Bible? Now they're reciting Bible verses. That must be nice. Flying all over hell and gone. And
how much longer?
Not time to read. Jesus, O'Brien. Don't. Okay, now I just gotta get the hell out of here before one of them spots me.
Secure. Something moved.
Yeah. Wasn't even my turn on the duty run.
O'Brien. O'Brien, are you there?
I can't talk right now. I'll be on this channel later. Out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. I'm getting tired of being your errand boy, O'Brien.
Said to get you.
I'll get to him.
Thanks, Deke. Hurry.
O'Brien. O'Brien, are you there?
I can't talk right now. I'll be on this channel later. Out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. I'm getting tired of being your errand boy, O'Brien. Ricky, what's going on?
That guy we've been looking for.
You were saying something?
That guy we've been looking for, Eric.
Anyway, you were saying...
Skizzle wanted to go after him, but Iron Mike said to get you.
I'll get to him.
Thanks, Deke. Hurry.
How's it going, brother?
No, Deke. I don't know about you, but I could use a hand.
You lay down.
Thanks, ma'am.
We can't have visitors just yet, but I could really use a hand.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
I'll be here. Hey, Doc, seriously, though. Will I be able to play piano after all this is over?
Very funny. William, lay down.
Okay. I could play chopsticks. No, seriously, I could. I'd be like...
As you can see, he's going to be just fine. His fever's completely gone.
Good, that's good. All right, well, I got to go take care
Deacon,
of some shit.
Like I said before, William really does owe you his life.
Boozer doesn't owe me shit. I owe him.
Hey, I saved two more. Eddie and Mia would have died without those antibiotics. I just thought you should know.
Seems like he's getting better. I can fix this. Good.
Let me get the gate.
Yeah, I'll see if I can make time. Deke out.
Deke, we need him alive.
Alive? Oh, come on. No, why?
Before he ran, he stole two bags of seed. Deke, we need those seeds.
Ah, shit.
We need to know where he sold them or stashed them.
You're making my day a lot more complicated. Okay, fine. I'll chase him down. Deke out.
Hey, what's this?
Could make something out of this.
Seriously, though, it's like I can still feel my right hand, you know?
That
think they call that phantom pain.
Yeah, that's what Addy said. It sucks. I feel pain in my finger joints, you know? Like, after a long ride, your hand gets cupped up, flex it. Anyway, I gotta get going. Skizzle got me on farm duty. Gonna see if I can pay off the MP meds that Addy has me on. Later.
Later. What the... Oh, Jesus,
Better have a look around, Deke.
How's that, huh?
Stop by. St. John out.
Deacon St. John.
Oops.
Look out. Hey, Deke, how's it going?
Hey, Damon, how's the gun trade going?
St. John, I got a bounty job for you.
I'm listening.
You're looking for Ned Walker. Wears a red scarf. He and his crew came to the gate the other night. We wouldn't let him in. He killed one of my guards, then took off.
You have someone to follow him?
He's holed up at a marauder camp just north of O'Leary Mountain. I think you know where that is.
No, but I'll find him.
Deacon, hey.
Damon.
How's it going, Deke?
Manny?
Cool. Need anything else? Yo, you need fuel? Look me up if you need anything else.
Let me get the gate.
Hey, stop by whenever you need something, all right?
Hope I'm at the camp.
Copy that. Cope out.
Hey, Cope. The man he killed. Who was it?
A young kid. Everyone called him Gopher. Never knew his real name.
Gopher. How old was he?
Like I said, a kid. 19, 20? No idea how he lasted this long. He was a good kid. Why are you asking?
No reason.
If you spent more time at the camp, got to know folks, maybe you'd find a reason. Cope out.
Finally, Jesus. It's done. You won't be here until that long.
Bring me his bandana. I want to see it for myself.
I know him. Open up.
Deacon St. John.
Nice work. Lost more than a few men trying to hunt down that son of a bitch.
Next time, just come to me.
You volunteering? Never thought I'd see the day.
My bike.
Go see Manny. If you got enough camp credits, he'll fix you right up.
Deacon St. John. Hey,
Haven't seen you around much lately. Thought maybe you'd gone up north without me. Hey, listen to me, okay? Stay safe out there.
Deke, how have you been?
Hey, Damon. How's the gun trade going?
Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life.
No, I'll keep an eye out for more shit. See you around, man.
Scrap. Let's see. That's it.
Damn it, sniper ambush. Oh shit, not now.
How'd you like that, huh? Shoot at me, you fucking bastard.
Fix this. Okay.
It's okay. Open up.
Hey, man.
Can I help you?
Deke, you ever ride with a drifter, scars all over his face, carries a tire iron, goes by the name of Limbo?
Don't know him.
He came into camp yesterday to turn in some bounties, have a few drinks. Seems like he didn't leave until early this morning.
Well, Tuck, I don't run security here, so why don't you just tell Alki about that?
He beat a man, Deke, and a woman to death. Bowman and Hewitt. Her face was so smashed in, you couldn't tell it was her.
Hewitt. Maria. Right?
Jesus.
This asshole, Limbo. He's a local.
Alki says they've set up shop at the old Forest Service watchtower on the east slope of Three Finger Jack.
Yep, I know where it is, and, I'll handle it.
I thought you might.
Can I help you?
Hey, what's going on?
Bike's a real guzzler. Come back soon.
I didn't do anything. All right. I've had enough.
See you around. Hey, man.
Hey, just taking a look.
Let me get the gate for you.
Oh, how's it going?
Thank you.
Doc, I'm here.
Yeah, looks like Limbo and his crew are calling. Come
on! Let it go!
What else can you tell me?
He wears a green coat. Looks like a goddamn leprechaun. You bring me his tire iron, Deacon St. John, and I want it covered in what's left of the son of a bitch's face.
I hear you.
St. John out.
Who the fuck are you?
Damn it! Find him!
Still got old iron tooth on you, yeah?
Here you go.
Fix this. That should do it.
fuel can. Needed this. That should be it.
I know him.
Hey, what do you need?
Can I help you?
Hey, Tuck. So, am I on your trust list or no?
You find that son of a bitch?
Yeah, here's old Iron Tooth, just like you asked.
Nice work. Deke, you're always the one person I could count on to get things done. You know, I have no idea where you and Boozer rode off to.
Get back
but it's
to work.
Good to see you.
Well, like we're around, Tuck, and if you need anything, you know how to reach me.
No. Go see Alki. No I'll update your credits.
Deacon!
Hold on, I'll get the key.
I've been pretty busy the past few days.
St. John, this is Ada Tucker. Alki wanted me to tell you that the camp is thankful for all the miles you've been doing. You need all the help you can get.
Tuck, hey, okay, I'll see you. If I can make time, Deacon out.
Here we go. Oh, here we go. That's it.
Stop moving, son.
Bring him down!
Shit.
Look out!
Move!
Go!
Cover him by!
Open the gate already.
It's deep.
Something?
Just looking for some stuff.
Deke, a group of men rode in, shot up the gate, and when we wouldn't let them in, they rode off.
Ah, shit. Which direction?
They headed west, but they didn't go far. They set up camp just north of Eden Hill. I think they might be planning another attack, so I need you to take a look.
Okay, right. Yeah, I'll handle it.
Thanks, Deke.
It doesn't look too bad.
I don't even know where to start with this thing. Shit.
No idea how to fix it.
Okay, Ricky, I'm near Eden Hill.
Yeah,
Drifter's still here.
Can you handle it?
I see you running around.
He's just running around! Get the bastard! He killed him!
Okay, Ricky, I'm near Eden Hill.
Yeah,
Drifter's still here.
Can you handle it?
Well, I guess we'll know soon enough. Deacon out.
All right, gentlemen. I thought you'd just swing by, shoot up the flies.
Okay, I think that's all of them.
Use this.
Okay. Tender, right, Joanna. Let Ricky know.
Deacon, how'd it go?
It's done. They won't be shooting up any more camps.
Whew, thank God. I'll let Iron Mike know. You know, keep this up and you and Mike are gonna be best friends before you know it. Right.
Deke, tracked down those boys, shot up the gate, and took off.
Hey, Mike, yeah.
Bounty.
Hey, Mike, yeah. I found them, and they won't be coming back.
Seems like it's getting worse. The amount of squatters and drifters we got coming through. No offense to present company.
I'll take it. And yeah, Mike, it's getting worse. I don't know. Mike, I think it's like you were saying about tourists always coming up here from California. Well, I guess if I had the choice, yeah, I'd rather be here than down there.
Yeah, I guess so. See you, Deke. Iron Mike out.
My day a lot more complicated. Okay, fine. I'll chase him down. Deacon out.
There we go.
Yeah.
of salmon were more important than heating our homes. To build those homes, the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry.
There we go.
Yeah, scrap.
bunch of murdering assholes can't let any of them get out of here alive.
Somebody's out here. Here you are.
Run all you want. I got you now.
First one down. Now the rest of you.
No, no, no! Bring it down! Bash his brains!
Crap! Someone's down!
A bunch of murdering sons of bitches. You like to set up ambushes, yeah?
Is that it?
Is that all you got? Yeah, that's what I thought. Next time you set up an ambush, don't pick on the wrong guy.
Well, I wonder if they had a bunker around here.
I'll bet they do. Here it is.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War, but living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. Man didn't know if his neighbor was an American who bled red, white, and blue, or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him, taught me the only way to be safe. In dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. We couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods.
It's like Mitch says, I hear a bunk calling my name.